Hi YouTubers, this is Lonnie Clark, Nuts for Art, and I saw Kevin's video today and I was glad he addressed all these false reports that are coming out that saying radiation isn't going to harm us. But it, actually, the reason I'm posting is because this is something near and dear to me. My daughter that I visited up in Portland this past weekend called me an extremist. And she said that, you know, we were talking about it, and she said her friend who tests water, he works for the government, he has assured her that the fish in Portland is fine, perfectly fine. It won't be in 5 to 10 years, so eat it while you can, because soon it's all going to be inedible. So they know it's bad. But, you know, when I talked to my daughter, I said, you know what, Sterls, ask that guy if he tests for tritium. Ask if he knows how they set the standards. The standards that they're talking about today are tremendously higher than what they were 5 years ago. So we're not even talking. And then reading this book by John Goffman, they didn't even have any real standards. It was just like, pick a number out of a hat and guess how many people are going to die. That's how they picked it. There is no safe radiation. There is no safe numbers, and people are dying. Right now, practically everybody and I know in Eugene has gotten sick this year. What happens with it's not even low-level radiation. We're being bombarded. It's starting to bioaccumulate. It's been 4 years. And I am, guess, venting because my own child, who's reasonable, we can have a calm conversation about it. We can talk about it at least. She thinks I'm an extremist because I'm telling her, don't eat fish, man. Like, seriously, don't eat fish. Minimize your dairy. Like, don't eat it as much as you can. I mean, we live in a culture that's really hard not to eat shit that kills you. That's really the bottom line. But radiation is like, bam, bam, bam. It's worse than just giving you liver cancer or you dying of a coronary. It's killing your children in the future with radiation. That's what's being missed. I mean, tell me if I'm wrong, but I don't think anybody who smoked cigarettes or, you know, died of a heart attack of a coronary because they ate bologna all their life, I don't think they're going to have mutated kids. I don't think the science is 100% firm on that one. Whereas with radiation, we know we're talking about not just death today, but death tomorrow, death the next year, for the next 200 or 300 years, mutated, weak, seriously struggling human. I mean, the ones who are going to survive, like me and my kids, we're going to be super strong. In fact, I am actually super strong. But it hurts my feelings, and it's really like, you know, I guess I'm venting and I'm asking. I had this idea that maybe we could do, like, since Dana's out getting the evidence off of the coast, you know, we could open up an online thing. Somebody who knows how to do background. I mean, I could do it, but it would be what? Just me talking at the screen and you guys chatting and me responding or something. But I think the idea of community in this issue is probably good for our mental health, because very few people have the courage to recognize that we have to live in it and we have to find solutions. We have to stand up. Or like my daughter, who it's not courage. She just really believes I'm 100% wrong because her qualified friend, her science friend, has told her that I have gotten really bad misinformation from YouTube and everybody out there is hysterical. And, you know, okay. I told her, you know what, Sterling? Read that book. Read the book that I'm reading or watch my videos online. Just listen to 10 minutes a day of me blabbing on and you'll get this and think about it and rehear it. Listen to it a couple times because it's big information. So anyways, I'm going to end here, but I'm hoping that the few people that follow my vlog will actually make some comments about, if you think it's valuable, we could set up, while Dana's gone, we could set up an online thing, a community where we could talk about some of this issue. I think it, for me, it helped, you know, and frankly, it would help. I know that there's the Hounds of Fukushima board, but I'll be honest, that's not the kind of thing I can even comprehend. I went there. I've gone online on there a few times. I don't get those kinds of, there's too many grids, too many lines, there's too many places to go. my brain, I don't see it. So anyways, I just guess I'm not going to be going there. So that's why I was thinking maybe this would be a good idea for me. Here I am again, being selfish. But it is a selfish act that we have to do. We have to do selfish acts for ourselves because it's about living. And, you know, life is selfish. We want to be alive. You know, if truth be told, you know, the earth could do without a lot of us, but we want to be here and we have to respect the earth and we have to help protect her and save her from the people who don't love our earth and love each other and who don't care about human life or any life at all. It's our responsibility to stand up to these people and make them stop. And make them stop now, because who gave them permission to lie to the scientific community en masse so that the scientific community lies to the masses? It's just like this bleeding thing that has got to stop. It's a level of insanity that is not just a crime against humanity, but a crime against all life. So I'm going to end here. Ciao, you guys. Talk to you later.